Bicycle riding is one of the most popular sports going right now with young people. I believe they're attracted to vehicles and the concept of speed right now. And a bicycle is the type of vehicle that they can very easily acquire and also work with and modify. At the school, the school provides a shop where they can learn the basics of mechanics and also use the materials that are available there to modify their bicycles, both for road racing style and also for the dirt motocross style. One of the current projects at the shop right now is the construction of a monoshock bicycle by Colin. This bike is being built for bicycle motocross. He's taken a small Schwinn Stingray and he's practically cut the bicycle apart. And he's made braces and brackets that allow the vehicle to swivel. And then he has placed a shock absorber in between the two portions of the frame. This design change is for bicycle motocross, which involves a lot of jumping and hitting berms on the side of the track, which keep the bike from going off the track. The concept is that the monoshock system will absorb the shock and therefore not transmit it to the rider.
Just takes the bumps out of the ride. If you're ridden on any dirt roads, you know what it feels like. And it keeps the back end on the ground. And if you're going downhill really fast and you hit a rock right before a corner and your back end's up in the air, you're not going to be able to slow down for the corner and you'll crash. With the monoshock there, the back end just doesn't fly up in the air. It stays on the ground.
Currently, the monoshock system is very popular in bicycle motocross, but it's not the only system that is being used right now. A lot of bicycle shops are selling these their own frames that they're building in their own shops, and these are being made available to riders who are sponsored and also to riders that purchase them for their own use. The bicycle motocrosser and the bicycle road racer have very distinct personalities. The motocrosser demands a sit-up style with a lot of leverage, has wide handlebars and a good sturdy seating position. Shorter handlebars and a tucked in riding position.
Every time we go down it's a race, but
yeah,
whoever has the inside on a corner comes out faster, so
yeah, there's
then,
rules, man. You have to call
whoever's call behind inside. You is also catching up to you because you're in the slipstream. So like you catch up behind the guy and you call the inside to pass him, and the next guy catches up to you after you just passed him.
How do you go faster?
If your hands are out on the grips, that slows you down. If you put them up towards the middle and kind of point them,
point your
like
hands.
You're praying or something, and it cuts the wind.
And duck your head down and just
behind
totally
your hands.
Tighten your body up, make it closer together.
Yeah.
Not so loose, just tighten it up.
Yeah.
Pull your knees in real close. Sometimes, like, if you're going into a left-hander, you hang your body over. So you hang your body over and stick your knee out.
Paul Smart style.
And the bike sort of stays level, so it keeps more tread on the road.
Faster are they?
Than the old bikes?
Twice as fast.
Which is about miles per hour.
No, they're 25 miles an hour faster probably.
Yeah, 50 to 60 on the fast ones.
How to ride the Pantor run.
Take it slow.
Just to let the bike carry them into the corners. You know, it's got good bank corners and it's got off camber corners.
There's only one that we have to break for them. That's right after the barbecue. It gets good after a while, like you ride with the same person like about 15 times, you get really good and fast. It gets to be really fun.
It has to be like a teamwork, though.
Yeah. I mean, you have to call out inside or tell them to take the inside if they want to go faster, because you just get shot out.
You can get lower into the corners because you got a lower center of gravity.
And less wind resistance.
Yeah, a lot less wind resistance.
Ass down it, and you have to take inside, or else you get swept to the outside and hit the cliff. Yeah. And the inside happens to be the other lane, so if the car was coming up.
You got kind of outside.
You kind of eat it.
Yeah.
Pretty soon, I mean, like after you go down about 15 times, it's easy. Yeah. You see a car, you can get out of the way real fast.
The only way you can smash your head is if you hit a car.
That's the main danger. Usually you can see ahead, you look through the trees and you can see if there's cars on a few corners you can't. You just chance it and if a car comes, you have to dodge it.